understanding deep inside that I am a human being responding to a situation. The deep inside, there's a sense of self will be there. Okay? So more and more as you get established in the pure consciousness, then there's no sense of the individual me. Okay. Any questions are there? Okay.
Actually, I don't find time to listen to anything at home. So I usually repeatedly listen to all the videos and this thing while walking, while go for walking in the morning times.
Does it help?
Yes, definitely.
Because the clarity? Okay. See, ultimately, the spirituality is just jnana, nothing more. Because adnana we have acquired from the society, that has to be replaced with the right jnana. And you have to go to nididhyasa, meditation. Again and again you have to go back to the real self. So that's all it is like. And it's not an attainment, one day I'll become enlightened, one day I'll become liberated, nothing like that. It is just, at any point of time, your real self is available to you. Whether you can go back is the question.
I do remember classes here, but one thing I keep remembering all the time is not to make anything center of my life, so I'll be weeping on it when I don't have it.
What?
Any particular thing, any material or something, center of my life, that if I lose it, I'll be weeping on it.
Okay. So, namaste.
I have only that thing in my mind.
Okay.
So, I'll be going.
Okay. Shishidhar is not coming? Okay.
Sometimes I'm becoming a society child.
Okay.
Because of unawareness.
Okay.
Most of the time I'm in consciousness. In divine
child. So any questions?
No, sir.
Just try to remember what all you taught whenever I'm in a situation. I don't know about any changes or progress. I think I still have to learn a lot.
Okay, what you have to learn?
More of being conscious and all that.
Okay. So are you unconscious now?
Not like unconscious, but less conscious.
Okay.
I used to meditate 5 minutes a day. Before going to office.
Okay.
But the thing is, when I feel that the oneness with the universe, at that time I got distracted. Every time that happens to me. Till that thought level has decreased. But you said we have to feel that oneness with the universe.
No, you don't feel anything. Just stay. See, the moment you say, I have to feel something, then you are trying to experience something.
But before that, when I usually comes to classes now, that time I didn't feel that. Between these days, the gap has happened. So between those days, I found that I meditated.
Okay. So what you do is just be still, silent. Don't ask, don't expect oneness or something, right? Just be silent. We'll discuss that.
And one more thing. If someone says something about me or anything, about anything, I don't know whether I'm neglecting that or am I accepting and I'm in conscious, with the consciousness I'm accepting that, or am I neglecting that? I didn't get the difference.
So, how does it matter in the sense?
No, like I just want, am I consciously I'm doing that or am I neglecting that?
No, I'm saying, let us say somebody shouted at you.
Huh.
Okay, then you didn't respond.
Yeah.
So then, what's your question?
Am I neglecting that?
No. It's the consciously, when you do, it's not neglecting. There are many things in life which don't require any reaction from us. It's a waste of time. Okay? Right?
Yes.
So now, that waste of time is you are aware. We are focusing on what is possible, what is required.
So I'm not neglecting that.
That's what I'm saying.
That was the change.
That's what I'm saying. Don't. It's not neglecting. It is focusing on the what is right. Right. I'll give you for example. You are going on the street. Somebody makes a comment on you. Okay. Let's say somebody does. So you can fight with him. You can take a chappal and beat him, make a lot of noise. But you'll spend some half a day on that. Or more than that. So question is it worth it? Neglect that fellow. As long as it doesn't hurt you mentally, just ignore and go ahead. If it's hurting you mentally, then you have to see why it's hurting you. Okay? So the cause of hurt is inside. Try to remove it. There are some situations in life requires action. Okay, that action you have to do. For example, your principal, the children of your school, children are in the school. The principal comes and tells your child is not studying well, so you are not teaching well. You are not taking care of your child. So he is commenting on you. Then you have to take action. Okay, he is not just generally making a comment on you.
Yeah.
So you have to find out why you have to take action. Where you have to ignore. Something you have to totally ignore. Something you have to focus. Right? So as you become more and more evolved, lot of things in life you don't even bother because it's not worth it. Right? For example, there are people, so political situation, let's say that Chandrayaan, this thing, they'll speak 2 days, full day, they keep on thinking about it. The mind is gone. It's not worth it. You have to focus on what is required. Somebody shouts at you, you keep on thinking for 1 week. It's a waste of time. Just focus. What is required? That's conscious. Right? Don't ignore what is essential, where your action is required. Where reaction is required, drop. Okay. So let us take up something else to do. Just remote it. Remote. Okay, so let us discuss today what is I and me. Is there a I and me are same or different? Pushpa?
I is referring to the consciousness, the real self.
Okay.
Me is referring to our identification with the
body mind complex. So, is this clear to everybody? I and me? The difference between I and me is clear to everybody?
No.
Right? So, didn't got that clear again? I and me is different. The me is the body, mind, and intellect.
Okay.
I is consciousness. Has your I any time changed? I doesn't change at all. It doesn't get born, it doesn't die. 10 years back it's same. And the I is same for everybody. Right? Okay? Whereas what is this me? The body, mind and intellect. The vehicle. So, the entire spirituality is confusion between the I and me. That's all, nothing else. The whole of spiritual life is wrong. There's so much of satsang, so many of the spiritual teachings, everything happens, no? It's only to remove the confusion between I and me. People are confused between I and me. Okay? So, when I say, Rupa, you look very nice, wonderful, okay? Yeah, you look very young. Rupa feels very happy. Right? So happy. Then somebody says, what the hell you are doing, Rupa? You are not doing working well at all. Rupa goes depression. Has anything happened to I?
No.
Okay. So if you know that I is not Rupa, then there is no depression. Both positive and negative situation in life, you face very calmly. You understand? The I and me are totally different, but they are related. How are they related? The me depends on I. Me cannot exist without I, but I can exist without me. Okay? Me constantly changes, but I doesn't change at all. Understand? So the me is changing, the I is not changing. Who am I really? The changing or the unchanging?
Unchanging.
But 99.999% of people, they don't know unchanging I. They confusing unchanging I with the me and get hurt or joyful in every situation of life. The moment you understand who is really I, the situation in life doesn't make a difference to you. You will write, respond. If you think I is me, then you react. Okay? If you know that I is not me, then you don't react. Are you clear? You want to show that screen?
Yeah, sure.
Huh? Okay. So, let us see the I and me. What is the relationship between I and me? I is called consciousness or awareness, pure consciousness or awareness. Are you clear? It doesn't go undergo any change. It is always silent and serene. Right? What is me? Me is the body. Me is the
mind.
Me is the intellect. Okay. So the I puts a me and experiences the world. I takes up a me. Okay. And while going back to sleep, it asks me is kept aside. In deep sleep, no me. It's exactly like what you are doing. Morning when you are coming here, you are wearing a new dress. Your dress. You are wearing makeup and coming here prepared. Right? So, I takes up a body and experiences the world. And in deep sleep, the body is kept aside and relaxing itself. You understand? The body is human body, the animal body. Okay? It's like a mask, you can say. Understand? Question? No? So in deep sleep, is there a body for you? Is there a mind for you? Is there intellect for you? Are you there? Huh? Did you attend, did I do the class for that waking state, dream state, deep sleep state, did I do for you?
Yes.
Miss Jagrati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti?
Yes, sir.
But
I didn't attend one class.
Oh, you might attend miss the important class. Right? Everybody else was there? You also not there? Okay, it's a very, very crucial class. Just to recap for the other people. In waking state, you call yourself a, let us say I call you as Miss Jagrati. Okay. Waking state, your name is Miss Jagrati. In dream state, your name is Miss Swapna. In deep sleep state, your name is Miss Sushupti. Miss Jagrati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti. Correct? So, yesterday night, you are now Miss Jagrati. Yesterday night, you had a dream. In dream, you went to Paris. Okay? You went to visit the Eiffel Tower and ate pizza. I'll ask you now, is Miss Swapna real?
No.
No? Miss Swapna real? Miss Swapna went to Paris. She had a pizza. Right? Is Miss Swapna real? Paris real? Not real. Sure?
Yeah.
Why? Why it's not real?
Dream.
Yeah, but dream is a dream, no? Why it's not real? Dream Paris is not real. Dream Miss Swapna is not real. Are you clear? So now, let us imagine that you are Miss Swapna. I'll ask Miss Swapna. She is in Paris now. Oh, Miss Swapna, is Bangalore real? For Miss Swapna, is Bangalore real? For her, Paris is real. Is pizza real? The pizza real? Yes. But is roti chapati real? No. So for Miss Swapna, Miss Jagriti is unreal. Miss Jagriti, Miss Swapna is unreal. Are you true? Now, are you the same? You are the same person?
Yeah.
How can you contradict yourself in two states? You understand it? Are you the same person? One moment you are saying Bangalore is not there. Other moment you are saying Paris is not there. How can you say that? Are you able to understand your contradiction? You yourself are saying that, no? Huh? So if I ask Miss Swapna, is Miss Jagrati's body real? This body? What she'll say? Miss Jagrati itself doesn't exist, she'll say. Just like you're saying Miss Swapna doesn't exist. So your body is unreal. Your Bangalore is unreal. Your problems are unreal for Miss Swapna. For you, Miss Swapna's problems are unreal. Miss Swapna's world is unreal, right? You are the same person, no? I mean, it's a split personality, right? Huh? The split personality disease is there, no? So you don't have one thing, you'll say somewhere else. Are you the same person saying the both things?
Yeah.
Then which of this is true?
The I is true, both are.
Both are unreal. So, Miss Swapna and Miss Swapna's world is unreal. Miss Jagriti and Miss Jagriti's world is also unreal. Okay? So now let me ask you a question. At this moment, are you Miss Swapna or Miss Jagriti? At this moment. Are you sure? Huh? So if you ask Miss Swapna, she will never say I am Miss Swapna. She will say I am Miss Jagriti only. In Swapna, in dream, she will tell your name only. The dream girl always tell your name only. She says I am that. Alright? Understand? So you will never be able to find out whether you are Miss Jagriti or Miss Swapna any time in your life. Because when you are experiencing a dream, dream appears real. When you are experiencing waking state appears real.
That Lucia movie.
So you will never be able to find out whether you are in waking state or dream state any time. You understand what I'm saying? For example, right now I'm saying you are sleeping in your house and dreaming that you have come to the class. Disprove it. You are a dream girl.
I had such dreams.
You had such dreams also. Your name is Kirtan, right? So, Kirti. So, Kirti.
Kirtini.
So, Kirtini, tell me, you prove me, you are actually sleeping in your house and dreaming that you have come to the class. I am a dream character in your dream. You tell me, disprove it. Because when you are experiencing a dream, dream appears very real. Huh? When you experience waking state appears very real. So, which is real? Because you only said dream is unreal. Dream girl says you are unreal. So which is real? Pushpa?
Yeah,
both are not real. Both are dreams in I. Okay. Your waking world is as unreal as your dreaming world. And who says so? You only say so. When you go to dream state, you say waking world is not real. When you go to waking state, dream world is not real. If you are telling both, same person is telling both, either both are true or both are false. Are you clear? So now you go to deep sleep. Okay? In deep sleep, is Miss Jagrati there? Miss Jagrati's world is real?
No.
Wow, Miss Jagrati has a lot of problems, financial problems, office work, so many problems are there. Miss Sushupti, does she care about that? She says your world is unreal, doesn't exist.
Yeah.
Miss Sapna's world also is not there. Now, is Miss Sushupti also you only? So, at three places you are telling three things. So, it's a split personality in three ways. In two ways, split personality, you go to doctor, psychiatrist. Three way, I don't know what to do. That's called samsara. So, in deep sleep, do you exist? In deep sleep, do you exist?
I exist.
Do you exist?
Sushupti exists, but not
the Jagrati. That's okay. Do you exist?
I don't know.
Huh?
Don't know, because again we fall back after
you later. No. Okay. Do you exist or don't exist? If you don't exist, that means there's a gap in your existence. Somebody who slept and somebody woke up. They are totally different. Now it's a bigger problem.
Something is happening. In dream also, okay, we remember some dreams, but the deep sleep part is missing.
Okay, you remember dream now? Some dream.
Yeah, yesterday's dream, yeah.
Yes. Okay. So, did you have a good sleep yesterday? Did you have a good sleep?
Yes.
Is that not remembrance?
Once we wake up, it's just peaceful. So.
Yeah. Is it not remembering, recalling that I had a good sleep?
Because the body and mind is energetic, because of that we can tell.
No.
Or peaceful.
See, you are not inferring. I had a good sleep is your experience. That's what you are able to say confidently. It's not an inference. You can tell something confidently about your experience only. I had a good sleep is my experience. That's what you say.
When you don't get dreams, you have a good sleep.
Yeah, that's it. That's called deep sleep, right? And if the deep sleep is missing for somebody, then they will become psychiatric patients. Mind will become blown out. Let's say the doctors will give medicine for it, right? So, did you exist in deep sleep?
But after we come to this state only, we come to know.
No. After this, you come to state only, you express. Don't confuse expression with the experience. Did you exist or not? I exist or not?
I exist. I is always there.
I is always there. Right? Was body there?
Yeah. I don't know.
No.
No, it was.
It is not there. That's what you say. Was there a body in deep sleep for you?
No.
Somebody else, your body was lying. But for you, there was a body in the deep sleep?
No.
For you, there was a mind in deep sleep?
No.
For you, there are any problems in the world there that is deep sleep? So in deep sleep, I alone was there. Correct? And what is your nature?
Peace.
Total bliss. Okay? So I exist means Sat. It's called Sat. Are you conscious in deep sleep? Are you conscious in deep sleep?
No.
How many people say no? Can you please raise your hands? Okay. Was there body in deep sleep?
No.
Was there mind in deep sleep?
No.
Was there intellect in deep sleep?
No.
Was there peace in deep sleep?
Yes.
So you know there is peace. You know that there is no body. There is no intellect. There is no world. Still you say, you are not conscious. You know what is positive peace is there. You know that the world is not there, body is not there, intellect is not there. Is that not knowledge? It's not awareness?
We just remember it. We don't...
You recall it.
Yeah.
Recall means what is experience you can recall. You cannot recall experience which doesn't exist.
At that point, we don't know.
At that point, you know. That's why you are able to recall. See, please understand, you are confusing. What is in my hand? Remote. Right? Okay. What is in my hand? So, you have a knowledge of nothingness. Knowledge of nothing being there is a knowledge. In deep sleep, do you have a knowledge of body is not there?
Yes.
Mind is not there?
Yes.
Intellect is not there?
Yes.
Bangalore is not there?
Yes.
The world is not there?
Yes.
You have a knowledge of absence of everything, my dear. Is that not knowledge? You don't have, do you have peace?
Yes.
Every day you go to deep sleep for that, every day you go to sleep because of that deep sleep, peace only. So you have positive knowledge of peace and negative knowledge of absence of other things. So still are you, say you are conscious or not conscious?
Conscious.
You are fully conscious. You are more conscious than the waking and dream state. That's why the deep sleep is very important. In deep sleep, you are experiencing your own self as peace. In deep sleep, you are experiencing the world is unreal, body is unreal, mind is unreal. Right? Do you exist in deep sleep?
Yes.
I exists.
Yeah.
Right? Me doesn't exist. Me is gone. I mean, you may say body is lying there, but for your experience, me is not there. Just keep it there. Keep it. Can I get? I'll take the basket.
Okay,
my will Nana is bring Malkundi. I'll Nana is the my will Nana is today. My illa Bear you or my will Nana will bear you cunning country. But only my illa not Nana. We'll find out, right? What is the use of deep sleep?
No, the knowledge of nothing. What is the use of that?
So knowledge of nothing, what is the use of that? So knowledge of something is always trouble. Your whole life is troubled because of knowledge only.
Correct.
See, what happens is, the moment you have knowledge, that's why Shivji, in Shiva Sutras, says Jnanam Bandha. Okay? So knowledge is your trouble actually. Okay, let me just give some knowledge to you. Your name is what?
Nidhi.
Hey Nidhi, you are overweight here. Just give some little bit knowledge to you. Now, it trouble starts. Okay, you have a little bit more knowledge. See, Gita is so slim. Your life is troubled only. Until you try to become like Gita, you will not be peaceful. See, please understand, knowledge causes disturbance in our consciousness. Okay.
Ignorance is bliss, Andre, but jivana madak kashta
alla. Alla, I am not speaking ignorance, I am speaking wisdom is bliss. Wisdom iku ignorance vyathyasa ide pa. You are actually confusing wisdom and ignorance. Ignorance and wisdom are totally different. A wisdom is a jnani. Ignorance is a fool. We are not speaking of fool, we are speaking of a jnani. So, knowledge causes disturbance to you. For example, next week, you have a surprise test in your college. Simple knowledge. Take any knowledge. Okay? So, why people think you think they drink alcohol? To forget everything. Forgetting everything gives some peace. That's not the right way. Okay? But nature has given a right way of forgetting everything in deep sleep. That's why you feel refreshed. If that half an hour of deep sleep is missing, you become go mad. That's why psychiatrist will give you medicine. Okay? But for most of the people, deep sleep is a state of ignorance. Nothing is there. In fact, reality, deep sleep is a state where your life is exposed. Your reality is exposed. In deep sleep, do you exist?
Yes.
I exist?
I exist.
Me exists?
No.
So, I alone exists. That is called Sat. Is there deep sleep peace is there?
Yes.
It's a positive experience?
Yes.
Ananda. Are you aware in deep sleep? If you're not aware, then how do you remember peace? See, please don't confuse being aware and expressing it. Expression is talk. The moment you talk, you are coming out of deep sleep. So you are experiencing it, enjoying it. That's why you don't talk. You can talk only when you come out of that. Okay? Expression and experience, don't confuse it. You have experienced some bliss in deep sleep. Then you say, no, I have experienced bliss, then you have come out of that. Experience is missed. So why you do that? You are mixing up experience with expression. Okay? To express, you need me, the body and mind. To experience, you don't need me, because it's your experience. Are you clear? Sat, Chit, Ananda. These three are exposed fully and deeply. Are you clear?
Yes.
Now, what is Sat, Chit, Ananda?
Which is the real Ananda, is it?
What is Sat, Chit, Ananda? Sat, Chit, Ananda is called God. Sanatana Dharma. Sat, Chit, Ananda is Brahman, Supreme Reality. Shiva andre adhe kanappa, that is Shiva. In deep sleep you are experiencing your Shiva nature fully. Are you able to understand? Okay. So deep sleep God has given to you to remember your nature every day. My dear, you are Shiva. In waking state you become me. You take up me. Then you become Jiva. Okay. And as Jiva, you go and struggle and do something. Nothing has happened to you. You are Shiva only. Come back to deep sleep.
Does it mean that we are in a deep sleep state when we are meditating?
Meditate is a waking deep sleep state. Right? You are aware that there is a deep peace. So you go back again and again to deep sleep state in meditation. Okay? So meditation is reproducing that deep sleep state.
But you will not be happy, you will be getting all the thoughts
That's no, no. See, this is where I have to correct it today. That's the class. So the thought is not an obstacle. I'll show you how. Thought at all. See, we are not trying to fight something. Okay. If you fight something, that it will build a stress. Meditation is not fighting with anything. Meditation is just relaxing. So how to relax with thought? I'll tell you. So are we clear? In deep sleep, your real state is always exposed. Okay. Satchidananda. Actually, Vedanta says you don't need any meditation or samadhi. Just understand your deep sleep state, you understand your real nature. This is the teaching of Vedanta. Your eye is fully exposed there. And that is the real knowledge. I am Shiva. Any questions?
Only that we don't carry it to waking state.
No, in the moment you take waking state, you put a new body, me. So now the experience, new experience will come. That original state is forgotten. The I is forgotten. Okay, you get stressed up, right? But it's not real you. This is only a mask. This is a what you have put on. Got it? Understood not? So, the teaching will happen only in the waking state. The realization also will happen in waking state only. So, for the waking state person, you have to explain based on the dream and deep sleep, my dear, you are not the me, you are the I. The jnana has to come to only the waking state person. And the waking state person only is restless. For him, you have to give some meditation to make him feel peaceful. Jnana has to come to the waking state person, and meditation is also for the waking state person. If waking state person is repaired, the dream state is also repaired, because dream state is a reflection of waking state. Deep sleep doesn't require repair. Are you getting me? So in waking state, you have to remember, I am Shiva, Shivoham. That you do through meditation. Are you clear? Even without meditation, the understanding that Shivoham because of deep sleep, that itself gives relief. Me is just appearing and disappearing. Okay? So, the pure I takes up the me. It's like a mask. You're showing this, Gayatri? It's like a mask. It takes a body, it takes a mask, it takes a woman, it becomes a monkey, it becomes a donkey to experience the world. And when going to deep sleep, it will drop everything and relax itself. In either way, waking state of I is not changed. It's only taking a role. Right? So for example, are you a mother? Are you a wife? Are you an employee? Are you a daughter? Are you a sister? Tell me who are you really here? You are telling so many things. Huh? You are telling you are a mother, you are telling a sister. How can you be so many things? I have, you real you have, nothing has happened to you. You are taking roles. Like the real I will take many, many roles, infinite number of roles. But nothing happens to real I. Are you understanding? The real I, the dog, it takes the role of a dog. It takes the role of a monkey. It takes the role of you. Nothing happens to it. I. It takes the role. How? Why? Experiences it. Are you getting what I'm saying? So, okay. When I am talking to you, whom I am talking to?
I is talking to I.
That's why we are able to understand. You understand? See, we are experiencing this one world as if there is a world. Not because there is a world, but the experience in all of us is same. are understanding? The objectivity, you will ask, oh, everywhere I experience this room. Okay? You think room is there because of experiencing. No. The experience of I in all of us is same. That's why you are experiencing it. The commonness is not outside. The commonness is? Are you able to understand?
Can you repeat that when I'm talking to you?
We'll take next slide, I'll tell you. Huh? Okay. First thing you understand, this body is a mask for I. It takes infinite number of masks. Why? It has infinite capabilities. Simple. Right? It's as good as saying you go to that Wonderla. You go on a ride, you go on a waterfall, you go on a slide. So you are experiencing different things. For experiencing the different things, I takes various bodies. But even if it take I takes various bodies, it's only I. Nothing has happened to? Understand? And that I is called Brahman. That I is called Shiva. That I is called God. And who is that I?
Huh?
You, Shiva. Your Shiva nature is fully exposed in deep sleep. Is it Jnana or Adnana? It is full Jnana. But in waking state, say, hey, deep sleep is nothing. That is your Adnana. You understand? That's why all persons on the earth, everybody likes a deep sleep. Even though they don't do any product, no make no money and all. But still, deep sleep is wonderful. The body is not there, mind is not there, intellect is not there. You and me is not there. Dog and monkey is not there. Everybody has merged with the I. Right? Every body. Body is the mask. Are you clear? And that is called me. The body mask is called me. You understand? Now, whole of the world, people live with the ignorance with the idea that me is I. They don't understand. I has me. The confusion between I and me is clear to you? Yes or no? Why? I'll say you are overweight. Okay? Is I overweight?
No.
Then who is overweight?
Me.
The mask. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So if the understanding the mask is overweight compared to I am overweight, what is the difference?
Relief.
Huh?
Relief.
Relief. Okay. Geeta is slim and you are overweight. So now you understand Geeta is nothing but I only. You are also I only. Then you don't feel jealousy about Geeta. You understand there is a problem with the mask. The mask problem, what to do, we'll correct it. But nothing has happened to I, which is real me.
But it's just a temporary soulmate. It's not like...
No, it doesn't mean that you don't have to work on the body.
Yeah.
Okay? But you don't take anything personally.
You don't get hurt.
You don't get hurt. That's most important now. So everything we start taking in life personally. Right?
Okay.
Okay? That taking things personally will stop. See, I mean, you might have heard the stories, right? So especially in terms of the life of girls. Some incident happens in life. Because of that, throughout the life they suffer. Okay? Yes, incident happen, but if you understand, it is for the vehicle, not for I. Then what will happen? You will not take it personally. See, taking things personally and not personally, there's a lot of difference in life. Is it there? Hey, you are a monkey. I'll tell you. The moment you take personally, you'll get angry. If you don't take personally, you'll laugh and say, do I look like a monkey? Is there some problem with your eyes? And you'll ask. The moment you take things personally, whole thing gets distorted. our vision of life gets distorted. We start going to reaction mode, not the conscious mode. Are you clear? Understand? Is this clear? So, there is a I and there is an object. This is called in English, actually English language has a very clear definition of this. I is called pronoun, right? You have heard of this? Has somebody told you there are two pronouns? I is called personal pronoun and me is called object pronoun. They are separate. Me is an object, not a subject. You understand? Huh? What is that?
Never heard.
I hear now. English, the English, they don't teach spirituality. I'm teaching spirituality in English.
Actually, both are personal pronouns.
No, 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 no.
This is subject. Technically speaking,
you're an English teacher?
I is actually a subject.
Subjective pronoun.
We use I as a subject.
Okay, subjective pronoun.
Yeah, subject pronoun and object pronoun.
Ah, that's correct. It's not personal. Yeah. Okay, subjective pronoun.
Both are personal pronouns.
Add with pronouns.
Huh?
What is it? Add with pronouns. No, no, no.
Add? What did you say?
No, I told I'm bad with this. That much of English pronoun.
Subject pronoun.
Yeah, object pronoun.
And it's called object pronoun. Okay.
We say object pronoun because it's used as an object.
Correct.
It is a noun case.
This is object pronoun, right?
Yeah.
So this
subject pronoun, correct.
Correct, no? But people take confuse subject pronoun with the person object pronoun.
Yes, that is right.
Right? So that is the mystery of life. That's all. Simple. Entire spirituality summary is this much only. When Ramana Maharshi says, who are you? Okay, he is telling, say, you are a subject pronoun, not object pronoun. Upanishad says, Tattvamasi, you are a subject pronoun, not object pronoun. Right? So clear, is the distinction between subject pronoun and object pronoun? Subject means real you. Object means object you are using it. The body you are using it. What you are using, don't confuse yourself with the O. And entire spirituality of anywhere in the world is only the confusion between subject pronoun and object pronoun.
Hmm.
Did English teacher teach you?
No.
You understood? When you understand what is real subject pronoun, I is pure consciousness, I is Shiva, and I am Shiva, okay? Object pronoun, which is body and mind, I am using it. So you will not, see for example, your clothes get torn, you will not get hurt, right? But if somebody speaks about your body, you will get hurt. Somebody speaks about cloth, okay, hey, what cloth you are wearing here, old clothes.
So you can change it.
You change it.
Body change.
Okay, now the question comes to change, right? The difference between subject pronoun and object pronoun is one important difference is there. What is that?
Change.
Subject pronoun I never changes.
Changes.
Object pronoun is continuously changing. My dear, did you have the same body yesterday?
No.
Half a million cells die every second in your body. Another half a million cells are regenerated in everybody. Once in 6 years, your entire body is changed. Okay, that's our body. Is your mind same yesterday and today?
No.
Half an hour back, your mind now is changed. Subject pronoun, I split it to do now. Subject pronoun and object pronoun.
It's peaceful now.
Intellect, understanding, was it same yesterday?
No.
Today. Is it changing?
Yes.
The me is continuously changing. The fashion consciousness is not today. The I is very fashion conscious. Every minute it changes its dress. You think Paris and London are fashion capitals of the world? Okay. The whole fashion trend started with Shiva. Okay. I. So here, every moment he keeps on changing. The me. The me is continuously here. Only thing is you are not noticing it. You understand? The changing me is the dress. Changing me is the vehicle. It's called object pronoun. And I is called subject pronoun. Actually, this subject pronoun, object pronoun, I didn't know. I gave a talk in America. Okay, the one professor actually, she's a computer science professor. Okay, she listened to my talk on the video and she immediately wrote to me, Prabhuji, what exactly you are saying is subject pronoun and object pronoun, there are two different things in English and you are telling exactly the same thing. Till that time, I didn't know the subject pronoun and object pronoun. I only knew Atma and Anatma. Actually, she read me a mail. I was surprised. Oh my God, these things also exist in English. I knew only pronoun. So, but I knew Atma. Atma and Anatma. I knew Vedanta Vakya, Tattvamasi. Oh my dear sir, in Tattvamasi you are saying difference between subject pronoun and object pronoun. That's all. Right? If you mix up these two, then you are in trouble. Okay? Life gets disturbed. Are we clear now? Okay? Please understand, entire spiritual teaching is this much only, one slide only. Tattvamasi, you are Brahman. You are a subject pronoun, not object pronoun. You are Shiva, subject pronoun. Then the moment you say you are Shiva, how can I be Shiva? I have not dressed like Shiva. I don't have a snake. I don't have water. Chata. Ganga is not there near me. Ganga, you know, you're not in water tank, there's no water. Where is Shiva? She'll ask. So my dear, you're confusing the mask of Shiva, the dress of Shiva with Shiva. The real Shiva is I. Shivoham, Shivoham. Got it? What is the nature of you really? Sat, Chit, Ananda. Okay? My dear sir, this is realization. If you think that there is some other realization, then you are missing it. A clarity of understanding is called realization. One day I will sit in Himalaya, some light will come, lightning will come and hit my head and I will get some lightning realization. It's aha, subject pronoun, object pronoun, they are different. Tattva Masin is I. So this understanding is called realization. Okay, how it changes your life is next level. Are you clear? Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Akhanda.
Ananda.
Anatha. Ananta.
Ananta.
Sana. Oh, sorry. Akhanda.
Akhanda.
Ananta.
Ananta.
Sanatana.
Sanatana.
Brahma.
Brahma.
Akhanda.
Akhanda.
Ananta.
Ananta.
Sanatana.
Sanatana.
Brahma.
Brahma.
Shivoham.
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 Shivoham. I am that Shiva. Please understand. I means I is Shiva. You understand? Okay? So the representation of I is what you do, Abhishekha. But that's a representation. Real I is Shiva. Your subject pronoun is Shiva. It's not specific for me. Oh, I am only Shiva. No. It is for I is same for everybody. Okay, so then, do you feel jealousy about her? She is slim and all?
No.
It is I only. You are only appearing as her. The I. But the moment you say the body is me, then she is separate from you. Right? Understand? So please understand, everything happening in your life, the good or bad, the relatives and friends, enemies, thieves, are nothing but you only coming back to you. I'll tell you, in a simple way to understand, in the waking state. Waking state is actually a copy of what's happening in the dream state. In dream, you went on a train. Hello, okay? You are going in a train. And one thief comes and picks up your pocket, runs away. And you shout, police, police, and policeman come and catches the thief and gives the purse back. Now, how many people are there in the dream? You only are in the dream. There are no three people. There are three bodies. Three bodies is not three people. You appeared as the thief. You appeared as a police. You appeared as a...
How can I appear as such contrasting personalities? Thief and police.
That is the power of I. Maya. It is capable of its infinite creativity. You can create anything out of nothing.
So how do I not know that even consciousness is created? That the feeling I have,
huh?
How do I not know that it is something created by Maya?
No, Maya is a word you are using. Your I is, I experience is, Maya, I experience is thought, is it?
No, what? No, teaching we are coming to know that consciousness. Huh? Otherwise, in general, people will not know. Oh,
that is, people, this is also false. People don't know is also false. Okay. See, for example, are you a sister? Are you a mother? Are you a daughter? Which of this is you? Can all of them be you?
Yes.
You can take all the roles, but you is not changed. That's why you are able to take all the roles. If you become a sister only, then you can't become a mother. How can you become a mother? So, these are all momentary roles you are taking. The I has not changed. This deep knowledge you don't have inside. Does anybody has to teach you?
Not even thought in that aspect if you would have not told.
Yeah, but it's naturally you know that. Right? I am taking the role of mother, I am taking this thing. So, you naturally know. Does anybody have to tell you that these are different things I take up, but still I am I? Anybody has to tell you?
No.
It's deep knowledge. Similarly, all of your deep knowledge that I doesn't change. 10 years back, how are you? Where are you?
I was changed.
I was changed. Has I changed?
No.
The deep knowledge is there. I am only pointing out what you know.
No, not that. You said that Maya has infinite capability.
No, what I am saying, don't worry, my words might take here. Yeah? I am telling you, the knowledge which you have, I has not changed. I am only pointing out what you know. Right?
If you have a bad dream and those characters are familiar, for an example, you take my cousin. She'll be in my bad dream.
Correct.
And something happens.
Okay.
Something happens. But when I wake up, I get affected by it. How do I not get affected by it?
Who is that I? Are you?
I got that, sir.
No, I'm saying you're getting affected because you're constantly mixing up I and me and trying to. You have to learn the separate I and me in the waking state. Because whatever your waking state experience is, it'll go to dream state.
But I feel very, fragile when I get up, if something happens with that.
That's because you see, that's what I'm trying to say. That's a waking state, dream state, deep sleep state. Right? Which of this is you?
None.
The I, which is none of this. That's why you are able to. Otherwise, these are three contradictions. Waking state is contradicting dream state is contradicting waking state, waking state, dream state is contradicted by deep sleep state. Correct? So I am none of this. I am the one where these are coming and going. Are you clear? So if this understanding becomes more and more clear to you, your waking state will be less stressful. Because you don't start taking anything personally. If your waking state becomes less stressful, your dream state also will become less personal. And gradually you realize that in dream state something happened to your cousin is nothing but your dream. You realize EXP started understanding it in dream also. It's a dream only.
I didn't get it.
What you didn't get?
It affects.
That's what I'm saying. It affects me. Not the I. So, is I and me same or different?
But sometimes I doesn't.